Yes, welcome students. Our lecture topic today is programmable logic device. In short, it is called as PLD. What we are going to see is introduction to the PLD, its types, and the basic PLD, which is called as PROM, that is programmable read only memory, the advantages, applications, comparison of them, and few problems related to it. First, you'll see what is PLD. So the name PLD stands for Programmable Logic Device. It's an integrated circuits, and it comprises of AND gates and OR gates arranged in an array. And the process of entering the information into these devices is known as programming. So user can program these devices or ICs electrically in order to implement the Boolean function based upon the requirement. So here the term programming refers to the hardware programming but not the software programming. And this is your general block diagram representation of your programmable logic device, that is PLD. So as I said, the PLD comprises of logic gates and specifically array of AND gates as well as OR gates, and either of them are programmable. And they are interconnected by means of multiplexers or switches. So this is the block which comprises of that. And it has got n input variables and you can produce m output functions out of it. To the types of the PLDs. So your programmable logic device is broadly classified into three categories based upon the number of gates, complexity of it, operating time, propagation delay, and some other features. The first category of this is simple programmable logic device. In short, it is SPLD. Second category is complex programmable logic device, that is CPLD. And third is field programmable gate array. In short, it is FPGA. In today's lecture, we are going to see what is a simple programmable logic device, and future lectures will carry what is CPLD and FPGA. We'll see introduction about all these three devices, how they are constructed. One is your simple programmable logic device. As the name suggests, it's a very simple one in architecture, and PROM is going to be the best example for this SPLD. It is capable of implementing hundreds of gates and normally programmed by the user by using inexpensive programmers. And the limitation of this SPLD is low logic capacities due to the restricted number of AND on the OR plane. So this is going to be a disadvantage of your SPLD. It is least complex and it is replaced by SSI and MSI devices. So what is SSI? Small scale integrated circuits, and medium scale integrated devices are replaced by means of this SPLDs. And this is available in IC packages with 24 to 28 pins in it. And this SPLD is further categorized into four more types of programmable logic devices called as PAL, that is programmable array logic, GAL, that is general array logic, PLA, that is programmable logic array, and programmable read only memory. The second type of your PLD is complex PLD. This complex PLD is a programmable logic device, and it comprises of blocks of macro cells which contains logic implementing, which are connected via multiplexers and switch matrix. From one PLD, it can be routed to the input of the another PLDs using interconnected arrays. And here the maximum clock speed is fixed and depends upon the registers used in it. Many PLAs or PAL can be included in CPLD chip, and it actually is a simple digital system. The propagation delay is about 8 nanoseconds and it's a low power consumption device. General block diagram of the CPLD is shown below. Here it comprises of n number of logic blocks which is built up of PLD. So this PLD can be either made up of PLA, that is programmable logic array, or programmable array logic, PAL, and like that it be having multiple number of PLD blocks. These PLD blocks are interconnected by means of interconnection matrix. Either it can be a programmable or it can be fixed. You are going to have multiplexers to connect from or select one PLD and route it to the another PLD and route it either to the input side or the output side. It is going to have the IO buses available. Third category of your PLD is field programmable gate array, or in short it is FPGA. So FPGA is an integrated circuit designed to be configured by a customer or a designer after manufacturing, hence the term field programmable. And here the configuration is generally specified using the hardware description language or HDL. It can be used for any specific applications, so is also called as application specific integrated circuit, that is ASIC. This FPGA comprises of logic blocks which includes memory elements which may be of simple flip-flops or more complete blocks of memories also. And this can be reprogrammed to implement different logic functions. So this is your block diagram representation of your FPGA. Similar to the CPLD, this is also going to have blocks of PLD, but here this is build up of PAL. It has got interconnection wires in between and IO blocks to interface or route to the output or another external device you can interface it. Out of these three types of PLDs, that is your SPLD, CPLD and FPGA, today's discussion is about SPLD, which we are going to see in. So first we will see what is SPLD and its type. So as I said, SPLD is going to be a simple programmable logic device which makes use of AND and OR gates. Either of them is going to be programmable, or it may be fixed also depending upon the classification. So here we are going to have the types of this SPLD. The first and basic type of SPLD is programmable read-only memory. In short, it is referred as PROM. It can be constructed by means of fixed AND planes and programmable OR planes. Second type is programmable logic array, that is PLA. Here this device has both the AND plane as well as OR planes to be programmable. Third type is programmable array logic or PAL. This device has a programmable AND plane whereas fixed OR plane in it. So this is how you are going to construct your simple programmable logic devices by means of the AND gates and the OR gates, which are arranged in array. Apart from that, we have got two more types in it, that is generic array logic, that is in short GAL, which is nothing but having the same logical properties of that of your PAL system, where it has got AND planes which are programmable and fixed OR planes. Another added advantage is it is erasable and reprogrammable. Here the next last category is field programmable logic array or FPLA. This has got the same properties as that of the PLA. Here also you can erase it and reprogram it. So the last two categories says that it can be erased. The program once written in the IC can be erased and you can change the program whenever needed. But it obviously says this, the first three categories You can store the program in it. You can't change any more. Further changes cannot be made in PROM or PLA or PAL. As I said, we are going to see in today's lecture what is PROM, how it can be constructed, and few problems how to implement PROM with the help of your PLD. The remaining topics will be discussed in later lectures. So as I said, there are various SPLDs. So basically there are three things in SPLDs: PROM, PAL and PLA. This is the block diagram representation of these three categories. So first is PROM, programmable read only memory, which has got fixed AND array and programmable OR arrays. These AND outputs are given as an input to R by means of programmable connections. Second is PAL, programmable array logic, where there are programmable AND gates arranged in an array, whereas fixed number of OR gates in it. AND gates are programmable, so they are going to have programmable connections given as an input, and the output of the AND is connected to the OR as a output. The third category is PLA, that is programmable logic array, where both the AND arrays as well as OR arrays are going to be in programmable way. You are going to have programmable connection to both the AND array as well as the OR array inputs. So all these three are the input variables to these logic devices, and these are the outputs of the logic devices. So we'll see what is PROM. So PROM is programmable read only memory. We have earlier seen in the previous lecture what is ROM. So ROM is a memory device. You can store binary information in it, but the stored information is going to be permanent. You can't change it by any means later on. So such a ROM which has got a programmable feature in it is called as a programmable ROM. The user has the flexibility to program the binary information electrically once in it by using a PROM programmer. So this is your block diagram representation of the PROM. So PROM has got fixed AND arrays followed by programmable OR arrays. So you have got a fixed AND array and a programmable OR array. This will give you the programmable connection. This will give you the input variables, and you can take the output functions over here. Now we'll see how to construct a PROM. So as I said, first block of your PROM is going to have AND gates which are fixed. They are not programmable. So there will be n inputs to these AND gates. You can generate 2 to the power of n product terms by using 2 power n AND gates in it. So we can implement these product terms by using n cross 2 power n decoders. So example 2 cross 4, 3 cross 8, etc. So this decoder will generate 2 to the power n minterms. And the second block is going to be the OR gate, which is programmable. So all these outputs, that is 2 to the power of n minterms, are the outputs from the AND gate, and it is applied as an input to the OR gates. Therefore, the output of the PROM will be in the form of sum of minterms. And we can program any number of required product terms. It is an added advantage of the PROM. We'll see the advantages of the programmable logic device. The design is flexible. PLDs offer customers much more flexibility during the design cycle, because design iterations are simply a matter of changing the programming files, and the results of the design changes can be seen immediately in the working part. So this is the best advantage of your programmable logic device. So whenever needed, you can change the programming files. Next is improved reliability. So lower power plus fewer interconnections and packages translate into greatly improved system reliability. Lower power, CMOS and fewer packages combine to reduce the power consumption, reduced complexity. So since PLDs are going to consume very low power, less board space is needed, so it has got very very simple architecture. So simpler testing procedures are used, hence we say it is a reduced complexity system. Next is PLDs are field programmable, so that is a programmer can change the program outside the manufacturing environment also, that is possible over here. And of course it is erasable as well as reprogrammable. So whenever you want to update the system or any device or any correction has to be made, if any error is present in the system, then it can be reused. You can change the design of it, you can erase it and reprogram it. So it is ultimately a reusable system. Coming to the applications, SPLD is a simple storage device. It can be used for core converters. It has been applied in data displaying, like 7-segment display, LED displays, data communications, and some controlling operations. Coming to the CPLD, it is a bit complex than the SPLD. So for some critical control applications, we can make use of the CPLD, cost sensitive applications, low power applications, loading of configuration data, and all these places you can use the CPLD. FPGA, of course, it is much more complex than your CPLD. It is going to have blocks of CPLDs in it. Like your CPLD is nothing but blocks of SPLDs, whereas FPGA is constructed using blocks of CPLD, so more will be the complexity. Here it is used for high performance computing, digital image, digital signal, digital video processing, speech recognition, high end radars. Now we'll see a few comparisons of this programmable devices. SPLD, it has got few hundreds of gates in it. Low to medium is going to be the density of your CPLD, where you are going to have about 500 to 12,000 gates in each and every IC. Coming to FPGA, it is medium to high, so almost there is going to be 3,000 to 50 lakhs of gates present in an IC. Timing is, in both SPLD and CPLD, you can predict it. It will be in few nanoseconds, whereas in FPGA it is going to be from medium to high. And there are some vendors in the market who supply all these ICs. So the vendors available are Lattice Semiconductor, Cypress, AMD, Xilinx, Altera. Here FPGA is supplied by Xilinx, Altera, Lattice Semiconductor, Actel. And the devices and its families are, Lattice Semiconductor is supplying two types of GALs, that is going to be erasable as well as programmable, which is going to be a similar PAL system, which is of version 8 and 10. And Cypress is a PAL with a version 8 and AMD with a version of 22. Xilinx supplies a family of Cool Runner and XC9500. Altera is Max. Here once again FPGA is supplied by Xilinx. The device families are Vertex and Spartan. Altera is Stratix. Lattice supplies Mac and ECP, and Actel supplies accelerator.